Great to have you back here on The Breakfast. Now, let's talk about what happened on this day in history. I'm going to be going back to June 4th in 1996. It was on this day that Kudirat Abiola was assassinated. And for those who live in Lagos, of course, it's a day that a lot of people would never forget, where she was followed and shot and killed inside her car, along with her driver. At the same time, of course, you remember MKO Abiola was in detention after the 1993 elections were annulled. And so she was killed here in Lagos while he was in detention. He eventually died in 1998, 2 years after her. She was known as Alhaja Kudirat Abiola, and of course, it was a Nigerian pro-democracy campaigner. Of course, wife of MKO Abiola, she was, or he rather, was a winning candidate in the elections in 1993 that was eventually annulled, of course, and he was arrested. The killing was subject to an investigation and a trial many, many years later. And according to accounts, the murder was ordered and carried out by six men. She died, of course, in her car from the machine gun fire. Her driver also died. Her personal assistant, who was later accused of being involved with her assassins, was in the car, but was not hurt in that assassination. Abiola eventually, of course, continued to remain in prison until 1998, when he was released, and then died not long after. If you remember, also in June 2012, Hamza al-Mustafa and Alhaji Latif Shofolaho were sentenced to be hanged for the murder of Alhaja Kudirat Abiola. But of course, everybody knows how that turned out. And also, if you remember the Oputa panel, I think that's one of the ones that for people who were very, very politically aware at that time, they will remember the testimony of Sergeant Rogers. They will remember the testimony of Hamza al-Mustafa with regards to Kudirat Abiola's death. It was a very, very sad, really, really sad testimony. But she continues to be an icon in Nigeria's democracy and democratic fight. She continues to be one of those people who, of course, couldn't eventually see Nigeria, achieve the democracy that it eventually did in 1999, but was a very, very relevant voice, a very loud voice in Nigeria's fight for democracy. So once again, rest in peace to Alhaja Kudirat Abiola and Moshood Kashimao Abiola.
Yes, rest in peace to them both. I'm looking forward to more intense and extended conversations about this in the coming days. And still today in history, the 4th of June, 1783. It was on this day that we had the first ever demonstration of the hot air balloon, and this was attributed to two French brothers, Jacques-Etienne and Joseph Michael Montgolfier. And they gave the first public demonstration of a hot air balloon, and it was heated by burning straw and wool. Now, this hot air balloon rose about 3,000 feet into the air, and it hovered for about 15 minutes before settling to the ground about 2 miles away. Then 3 months later, the brothers sent a sheep, a rooster, and a duck afloat in one of their balloons. And later in October, they demonstrated the first untied hot air balloon flight. Now, two men flew 5.5 miles over Paris in about 25 minutes. And these brothers were aviation pioneers. They were credited with inventing the first successful hot air balloons and were honored by the French Academy of Science for their achievement. So when you're talking about innovations in, you know, flight, aviation, the airplanes and all of that, we can all make reference to these brothers for, you know, making the first demonstration and just making sure that they prove to people that with science, you know, anything is possible.
I'm not sure if it was hot air balloons or it was airplanes that the trial flights were, you know, I think you mentioned a pig and a chicken or something like that. And then after that, they used condemned criminals. I think it was hot air balloons. I need to confirm. But in the initial stages, while they were doing trials, while they were still testing the whole idea of hot air balloons, I think they had used condemned criminals as part of, passengers. Mm-hmm. To see, of course, if it was going to be successful.
Yes.
And, you know, obviously, if the If there was disaster, it would be people who were already condemned to death in that time. You know, and some other thing, of course, that's fascinating is, you know, how as early as that time, this is what, 18th century or so, there were already people who were thinking maybe we could fly in balloons. Mm-hmm. Maybe, you know, it's possible that we can use these chemical reactions and this and that, and, you know, and pump some, you know, hot, you know, air in this balloon and make it, you know, go all the way up. There have been a few disasters, hot air balloon disasters, you know, even not too far, just a couple of years ago. Mm-hmm. But it's still, you know, a pretty interesting leisure activity. Very expensive to get on, but, you know, still very, very interesting activity. So kudos to the both of them and every other person who, of course, contributed to that invention. I hope that I can get on one someday if I can defeat my fear of heights sometime in the future.
Yes, that's it for you today in history, 1783 and 1996. We'll take a break here and come back to our first major conversation.